But hello, in previous class, we have seen about the concentration of solutions. So what are the methods to express the concentration of solution? See here, these are some methods are there to express the concentration of solution, right? These are a few methods are there to express the concentration of solution. Among all these method of concentration of solution, the first method which one we are going to discuss today, that is about the molarity. But what is this molarity? So I should say denoted as a M. What is the formula of molarity? So molarity equal to small n by volume is in liter. What does small n indicate? You know, small n indicate that is the number of moles. That is the number of moles of solute, and volume V indicate it is a volume of solution. It is a volume of solution, and that is in the liter. That is the formula. Just remember here, molarity equal to number of moles by volume in liter. But if you know the molarity, we can say molarity equal to number of moles by volume in ml into 1000. This is the second formula we can make. Even we know that formula for number of moles. But we saw type 1, type 2 and type 3 concept of mole. Type 1 concept means that is the number of moles equal to weight given by gram molecular weight. Type 2 concept means number of mole is equal to number of particles by Avogadro's number. Type 3 concept of mole means number of moles equal to volume of a gas given at the liter by 22.4 liter. So you can use any one. But better we have to use the first type, that is N stand for number of moles. That is weight given by gram molecular weight. But at this value of N substitute here, see we are able to get one more formula. That is a weight by gram molecular weight. Means number of moles is nothing but the weight by gram molecular weight. Either the volume of the solution is given in the liter, or the volume of the solution is given in the ml. That is weight by gram molecular weight into 1 by V, means we can say 1000 by volume of solution is in the ml. See, beta, these are the formulas for the molarity. So remember, N stands for number of moles. V stands for volume of solution is in the liter. If volume is given in the ml, what you will do, beta? Volume is in ml into 1000 by volume is in ml. Number of moles means what? Weight by gram molecular weight. So I can say here, weight by gram molecular weight into 1 by V in liter or 1000 by V in ml. That means how to define molarity? So I should say it can be defined as, see, but N stands for number of moles. Number of moles of solute, right, beta? It can be defined as, and what this N denote? Number of moles of solute present in 1 liter of its solution. See, this is a definition for molarity. Number of moles of a solute present in 1 liter of its solution is called as a molarity. Any doubt, beta, on this definition? So formula one, we extended volume in ml with 1000 by V in ml. In place of number of moles, we are putting weight by gram molecular weight, 1 by V in liter, or weight by gram molecular weight into 1000 by V in ml. And this is a definition for molarity. But they can ask you the term called as a unit of molarity. What is the unit of molarity? You know, see, N stands for units of molarity, right? Unit of molarity. What is the unit of molarity? You know, but N stands for mole, V stands for volume. So by volume means per liter. So mole per liter is the unit of molarity. Mole per liter is the unit of molarity. बेटा मोलैरिटी इज अ टर्म, आइदर इट इज ए टेम्परेचर डिपेंडेंट और टेम्परेचर इंडिपेंडेंट. प्रीवियस क्लास में डिड यू सॉ आई मेक वन चार्ट राइट. सो हियर आई कैन से मोलैरिटी इज द टेम्परेचर डिपेंडेंट. मोलैरिटी कैपिटल एम, दिस इज द टेम्परेचर डिपेंडेंट. मोलैरिटी इज द टेम्परेचर डिपेंडेंट. इज इट क्लियर? So these are the formulas are there, definitions, units and temperature dependent. But we'll try to do some numerical based on that one. But before that, I want to tell you some more concept. Listen here. What is the concept we required here, beta? We should know gram molecular weight of the compound. Anyhow, you know how to find out the gram molecular weight. But better way, you buy at this one. Gram molecular weight of NaOH. See, but I will tell you, sodium is 1, atomic weight of sodium 23, plus oxygen is 1, atomic weight of oxygen is 16, plus hydrogen is 1, atomic weight of hydrogen is 1, that is equal to 40. If I will ask you what is the gram molecular weight of NaOH, you should say 40 gram per mole. What you should say, beta? That is equal to 40 gram per mole is a gram molecular weight of NaOH. What is the gram molecular weight of sulfuric acid? But a hydrogen is 2, atomic weight of hydrogen is 1. Sulfur is 1, atomic weight of sulfur is 32. Oxygen is 4, atomic weight of oxygen is 16. And if you solve, 98 gram per mole is a gram molecular weight of sulfuric acid. Is it clear? Very good. Third one, what is a gram molecular weight of nitric acid? Hydrogen is 1, atomic weight is 1, plus nitrogen is 1, atomic weight of nitrogen is 14, plus oxygen is 3, atomic weight of oxygen is 16. And if you solve it, I will get gram molecular weight of this HNO3 called as a nitric acid, that is 63 gram per mole. But I can write per mole or we can write as a mole inverse. Both are same thing here. NaOH 40, H2SO4 98, HNO3 63. But sodium hydroxide, sulfuric acid, nitric acid. Any doubt, beta? Fourth one, I will say HCl, hydrogen is 1, atomic weight 1, chlorine is 1, atomic weight 35.5, and that is equal to 36.5 gram per mole is the gram molecular weight of hydrochloric acid. So please buy at this one. Gram molecular weight of NaOH is 40, sulfuric acid is 98, HNO3 is 63, and HCl is 36.5. Right? Take a screenshot or write down this one. But now, as we wrote a formula for molarity and all, I will try to do some numerical based on that one. Before that, this I want to ask you, see, these are the formulas we are going to use. Molarity equal to number of moles by volume in liter. Molarity equal to number of moles by volume in ml in 2000. But a molarity equal to weight by gram molecular weight into 1 by volume of solution is in the liter, or molarity equal to weight by gram molecular weight into 1000 by volume is in ml. But all these formulas which one I wrote here, I'll take the use of these formulas. And you know, beta, sodium hydroxide molecular weight 40, sulfuric acid molecular weight 98, HCl hydrochloric acid molecular weight 36.5, but a nitric acid HNO3 molecular weight is 63. Right, these things you have to remember. But a question number one, calculate molarity of, but a molarity of 2 moles of NaOH in 1 liter of solution. See, what is the how the question was given? They are asking to get the molarity. So, what are these all are the molarities? They have given 2 moles of NaOH. So, number of moles is there. Volume of solution is in the liter. So, volume is the solution is in the liter. I should use first formula. What is that? Cl. But a molarity equal to number of moles by volume of solution is in the liter. Number of moles 2, volume is 1, that is equal to 2 molar. But you can write it as a 2 molar or you can make it as a 2 mole per liter. Because molarity, unit of molarity is what? Mole per liter. So first formula is here. But a second formula I want to make here. Calculate molarity of 2 moles of NaOH in 500 ml of solution. Means this is the volume of solution is given in the ml and mole is given. See, beta mole is given and volume is given in the ml, asking to get the molarity. The molarity, number of moles, volume is in ml. I should use second formula. And now my this one, molarity equal to number of moles by volume in ml into 1000. But a number of moles is 2, volume in ml 500. Then it become into 1000. It 1s are, it 2s are. 2 into 2 beta, 4 molar. Or we can say 4 mole per liter. 2 into 2, 4 molar. We can say beta it is a 4 mole per liter is the molarity of the solution. Is the molarity of the solution. Now third one's here. Because I want to use all the 4 formulas by putting one example. Suppose they ask us to get the molarity of Hamada, molarity of 49 gram of H2SO4 present in Hamada, 49 gram of H2SO4 present in 500 ml of its solution. Now what they have given, according to that, we have to go with our selection of these formulas. But they are asking to get the molarity, right? Weight of the solute is given. Volume of the solution is given in ml. But weight, volume is in liter. Weight, volume is in ml. Use this formula. What is that? Molarity equal to weight by gram molecular weight into 1000 by volume of solution is in the ml. But what they gave? They gave weight of solute. They gave weight of solute. What is that? 49 gram. But what is the gram molecular weight of sulfuric acid? I ask you to by add. That is 98. See, it is written here. 98. Now they gave volume of solution also. And this volume of solution they gave as a 500 ml. Volume of solution also there. So what we can do? Put up on this one. Molarity equal to weight by gram molecular weight into 1000 by volume of solution is in the ml. But it become 2 times. It become 2 times. 2 to get cancelled. It become a 1 molar. Or we can say it is a 1 mole per liter. See, but 1 molar also we can say. Or 1 mole per liter also we can write. Okay. Please note down or take a screenshot. Now, but the next question which one I gave here. Calculate the molarity of 4 gram of NaOH present in 2 liter of its solution. See, here they are asking to get the molarity. But what is that? Weight of solute by gram molecular weight of solute. Volume is in liter. So I should use 1 by volume of solution is in the later. So weight is given 4 GMW of NaOH 40 into 1 by 2. But 4 by 40 means 1 by 10. 1 by 2 means 0.5 by 10. That becomes 0.05 molar. Or we can say 0.05 mole per liter. Understood, beta? Weight is given. Gram molecular weight 40. 4 by 40 into 1 by volume of solution is in the liter. Means 1 by 2, 0.5 by 10, 0.05 molar or 0.05 mole per liter. Very good, beta. Very good. One more you tried. Calculate molarity of 98 gram of sulfuric acid present in 500 ml of its solution. Present in 500 ml of its solution. But it's a very simple. Please try it and let me know the answer. See here, beta. Molarity is equal to weight of solute by gram molecular weight of solute. Volume is in given ml. 1000 by volume is in ml. Weight is 98. Gram molecular weight of sulfuric acid also 98. Beta into 1000 by volume of solution is given in the ml. 500 twos are 1000. 98 cancel. It is a 2 molar. Or we can say it is a 2 mole per liter. 2 mole per liter. Right? See, beta, once again, where you did the mistake. Check it once. But after this one, we'll try again 2 more questions. Calculate the molarity of we'll use this nitric acid. Molarity of 6.3 gram of HNO3 is present in 500 ml of solution. Try this one and second one, this one, beta. Calculate the molarity of 40 gram of NaOH is present in 250 ml of its solution. Try, beta, these both questions you have to try it. It's a very simple. Try it, beta. Now listen here, beta, I will explain you. They ask us to get the molarity. They give weight of solute directly. Do you know HNO3 ka molecular weight? 63. But a volume is given in the ml. So I should use 1000 by volume is in ml, it become 2 times, it become 1/10 times. Very good. Try this one, beta. Molarity equal to weight of solute. Beta, NaOH gram molecular weight 40. Volume is still given in the ml. 1000 by volume is in ml. 4 times. That is 4 molar, or we can say 4 mole. Per liter is the molarity of the solution, right? About this question, which one we did here, all here, directly they used to give the volume for us, they used to give the weight of the solute, and they are asking the molarity. Now differently we'll see here, differently in the sense, but they give the molarity, they give the volume, and they are asking the mass. See here. One question I want to explain you. Calculate the mass of sodium hydroxide NaOH. Now they're asking mass. Calculate the mass of NaOH, sodium hydroxide, present in 2 molar of 1 liter. Of its solution, means volume is given in the liter, molarity also given, beta, molarity also given, but they are asking to get the weight, mass. So now see here, volume is in liter, this one, so directly we can use this third formula. I will write here, beta, molarity equal to mass of the solute by gram molecular weight of the solute into 1 by volume of solution in the liter. But you want weight to write down, sir. Weight of solute means mass of solute, that is equal to molarity into gram molecular weight into volume of solution is in the liter, because gram molecular weight goes here, volume is in the liter goes here. So what is the molarity, beta? It is a 2 molar. What is the gram molecular weight of NaOH? Sir, it is a 40 into volume of solution is in the liter 1. 40 into 2, so 80 gram is the mass of the NaOH. But if you understood this one, please try the second one. I want to give for you. Calculate the weight of sulfuric acid. The weight of sulfuric acid present in 0.2 mole of 2 liter of its solution. Right, beta? What you have to calculate? Weight of the solute present in 0.2 molar of 2 liter of its solution. Sulfuric acid, molecular weight 98. Please try it and let me know the answer, beta. What is the answer you are going to get? In this case, but the weight of solute they are asking. Molarity gave, volume is in the liter. So molarity equal to weight of solute by gram molecular weight of solute into 1 by volume of solution is in the liter. But these things means I want the weight color. I'll write here. But the weight of solute, gram molecular weight comes here, volume comes here. Molarity into gram molecular weight into volume of solution is in the liter. What is the molarity we have, beta? 0.2. Gram molecular weight sulfuric acid 98. Beta, into volume of solution is in the liter 2 liters. 0.2 into 2. 0.4 into 98. Beta, 98 four times. Right, 392 by 10, 39.2 gram. Very good, excellent. Very good, beta. Right? Chalo, take a screenshot of this one. But a few more examples I want to give for you in a very simple way. For example, direct question is given. Calculate the molarity. Calculate the molarity of the following solution. Yes, you have to calculate the molarity of the following solutions. I want to give solution for you. Just listen here. Simple examples are there. First one, 40 gram of NaOH is present in 250 ml of solution. Right? It is the first one. You have to understand. Solid. Second one, beta, 4.9 gram of H2SO4 is present in 500 ml of solution. Right, beta, here. Right? Because one we did the NaOH, second one we are doing with a sulfuric acid. Then third one, only these two you do, beta, first. Then I'll give the third question based on the other topic. Try it and get the answer of these two. Now listen here. They're asking to get the molarity of the following. Means weight of the solute, volume is in ml. Weight of the solute, volume is in the liter, we don't want. Weight of the solute, volume is in ml, we want this one. So can we write better directly? Molarity equal to weight of solute, gram molecular weight is 40 into 1000 by volume of solution is in the ml. But it cancelled four times. This is cancelled. We got 4 molar. But a 4 molar can be written as 4 mole per liter is the molarity of the solution. Very good, beta. Very good. Right? Second one we'll write. Molarity is equal to weight of solute by gram molecular weight of solute 98. Sulfuric acid, na beta. So 98 into volume is in ml. 1000 by volume is in ml. It get cancelled, become 2 times. 4.9 beta 1 by 10. That is 49 by 10 into 1 by 98. Again into 2. 1s are, 2s are, 2 cancel. 1 by 10. It become a 0.1 molar. Or we can mention it as a 0.1 mole per liter. Very good, beta. Very good. Take a screenshot of this one. We'll go some more examples.
Done, sir.
Topic is very simple, but we have to do all the count or model problem based on this one. Now, one more question they gave. This time they are giving beta for us the mass of the, or they will ask us to calculate the mass of the solute. Volume they will give and molarity they will give. Chalo, I want to explain you beta. Calculate the mass of sodium carbonate solution. Sir, you didn't give the molecular weight of sodium carbonate. Don't worry beta, I will give for you. Beta, Na2CO3 gram molecular weight become 106. If you solve it, it become a 106. Calculate the mass of sodium carbonate whose molarity is 3 molar and we can mention its volume as 100 ml. Mass of sodium carbonate solution in 100 ml of 3 molar solution. Means they give molarity, they give volume, and they are asking to get the mass of the solute. I hope you can do it, beta. Please try it once, then I'll explain you. Try it, beta. See, Rada, mass of sodium carbonate asking. Volume molarity is given. Molarity equal to weight of solute by gram molecular weight into 1000 by volume of solution is given in the ml. So we are using this formula. I want weight of solute. What is the solute? Sodium carbonate. Molarity into gram molecular weight into volume in ml by 1000. But a molarity given 3. Gram molecular weight of sodium carbonate 106, right, beta? 106. Volume is in ml 100. Right? 100 by 1, 2, 3. 6 into 3, 3, 6, 18, 8, carry 1, 1, 3, 1s are 3, by 10, 31.8 gram. Very good, beta. You are able to do these kind of the questions. Very good, very good. Chalo. Beta, we will do some kind of the questions called as asking the molarity if the density is given. Asking the molarity if the density is given. Right, chalo, I will make you to do these kind of questions. It's a very simple. Now our molarity may difficulty level will increase, beta. Why? Because these all are the very simple problems. At least we should know what is the molarity, how to solve, how to calculate the molarity, how to get the weight if the molarity and volume is given. All these things are there. Now, additional part I want to tell you. Here all we wrote, acid, base and all. But one more write-up. The name of compound is a urea. And urea is written as a CO, where NH2 taken two times, whose molecular weight if you want to find out, but its molecular weight become a 60, right? Molecular weight become a 60. One second, beta, one second. Now, beta, here one more molecular weight I want to introduce for you, called as the urea. But a formula of urea, see, I wrote CONH2 taken two times, whose molecular weight is 60. Why? Because I'm going to give the question based on that topic only. See here, how the question is, 120 gram of urea is present in, 120 gram of urea is present in 1 liter water. See, but they didn't give the volume of the solution. No. They gave volume of the solvent. You remember, solution is made up of two components. One is the solute, other one should be a solvent. Together we'll make a solution. So they are present in 1 liter of solvent, that is 1 liter of water. Then calculate molarity of, but calculate molarity of solution. You know, density of the solution, they give, this is a given data is there. What is that? Density of solution is 1 gram per ml. They mention like that. We'll do better. Density of water is 1 gram per ml, we'll do. And density of solution is 1.12 gram per ml, we'll do. It's a given data, beta. Density of solution is this one and density of water is this one. They are asking to get the molarity. See, beta, how interesting question is there? I'll show you. Molarity, yes, sir. Beta, weight of solute by gram molecular weight of solute. Check it, volume is in ml or liter? Sir, liter. Beta, volume is in liter and actually what we want? We want volume of the, this volume of the solution we want. And we know it is a volume of the solvent is there. Correct, beta? volume of the solvent is there. We want volume of the solution. What to do? See here. Density is equal to mass by volume. Right, beta? Volume of the solution should be equal to mass by density. This is a mass of solution by this is a density of the solution. But a mass of the solution means what? Where it is mass, we don't have. We don't have, but volume of density of solution we have, beta. Mass of solution we don't have. So we have to get the mass of solution also. Are you getting me? I want volume of solution. For getting volume of solution, I am using this formula. What is this formula, beta? Density equal to mass by volume. So volume comes here, mass by density, mass of solution by density of solution. See, beta, density of solution is given. Mass of solution is not given. I want mass of solution. How to do? See, I'll show you. Sir, mass of solution is equal to mass of solute plus mass of solvent. Mass of solute plus mass of solvent. Beta, what is the mass of solute? What is the mass of solute? Sir, given 120 gram. Sir, what is the mass of solvent? Beta, 1 liter is there, na? Can we say 1 liter equal to 1000 gram? Sir, how you know? That one I'll tell you again, beta. See here, volume of solvent. Water is given 1 liter. Beta, 1 liter means 1000 ml. And do you know, density of water is 1 gram per ml. So, beta, 1 gram per ml, ke liye, what is the density? What is the mass of the water we can write, beta? So, mass of the water, 1000 ml become a 1000 gram. Because 1 ml solution mass is 1 gram. So, 1000 ml solution mass is what? 1000 gram. So, beta, mass of solvent, 1000 gram. It is equal to how much? 120 is the mass of solution. Now I can apply here. Mass of solution 1120. What is that? Gram. Density of solution is 1.12 gram per ml. Gram get cancelled. Solid beta. I'll get volume of solution. This volume of solution substitute here. I'll get molarity. Weight of solute 120. Gram molecular weight of urea 60 into beta, shall we write now 1000 by volume of solution is in the ml, because I got volume of solution is in the ml. So molarity equal to beta, it become a 2 times 2 into 1000 by volume of solution is in the ml 1120. The term which is at the denominator comes at the numerator. And now you solve it, beta. 2 into 1000 by 1120 into 112 by 100. This 20 get cancelled. This also get cancelled. This also get cancelled. Last my answer is what? 2 molar. Answer is beta, 2 molar. Very important concept. Here, volume of the water is given 1 liter. So volume of water is solvent 1 liter become 1000 ml. And we know, for 1 ml, it is 1 gram. So, 1000 ml should be 1000 gram. So, mass of water 1000 gram means it is a mass of solvent I got 1000 gram. But a mass of solute already we have 120 gram. Total mass of solution 1120 gram. Substitute here by density you have to do. Volume of solution we are getting in the ml. That volume of solution we are getting in the ml. Substitute on these case where we are getting the molarity of the solution is 2 molar, right? Check it, beta, once. If any doubt is there, please ask to me. But now this is one of the question is given. Calculate the molarity of 10% W by W aqueous solution of sulfuric acid if the density is given 1.1 gram per ml. See here. We know that 10% W by W means what? So I should say Sir, it is a 10 gram of solute. Do you know, beta, what is the solute here? Sulfuric acid is a solute. 10 gram of solute is present in, beta, another W, percentage is kada, present in 100 gram of solution. Because it is a weight of solute and this is a weight of solution. Actually, what we want, beta? We want weight of the solute, yeah. And we want volume of the solution for getting your molarity. See, molarity equal to weight of solute by gram molecular weight of solute into 1000 by volume of solution is in the ml. What are the values we have? Weight of solute. What is the weight of solute, beta? 10 gram. What is the solute? Sulfuric acid. What is the GMW of sulfuric acid? Sir, 98. Into 1000 by a reser volume of solution in ml only we want. We don't have. We are having mass of the solution. Apply the formula, beta. Density of the solution equal to mass of the solution by volume of the solution. Sir, volume of the solution should be equal to mass of the solution by density of the solution. What is the mass of the solution we have, sir? 100 gram. But what is the density of solution we have, sir? 1.1 gram per ml. ml goes on the numerator. Gram, gram, get cancer. The volume of solution equal to 100 by 1.1 ml. These values substitute here. Molarity equal to 10 by 98 into 1000 by, see beta, volume of solution is in the ml. What is that? 100 by 1.1. It goes here. 1212. Right? 100. And this one we got. 10 into 10, 100. Beta, 1.1 can be written as 11 by 10. Divided by 98 into 1, 98. 0, 0 get cancelled. 11 into 10, 110 by 98. Beta, solid will get the answer. This is the molarity of the solution. Got the point? Take a screenshot, beta, of this one.